Hi, everybody, and welcome to KieronTV.com and Your Purposeful Life. You guys remember this? I was using this for another teaching for a group overseas, and I thought I'd leave it up because it actually refers to part of our lesson today. So let's continue on. I really do hope you're enjoying these lessons and that you're really doing the work to help determine your purposeful life. I'm getting some emails from people saying they're really enjoying it and it's really helping. So that's fantastic. I'm so happy. So let's continue on. The ego. The ego is the part of you that governs your identity. It establishes your identity, and the ego also works hard to preserve your identity. It also works hard, the ego works hard to keep you safe and in a comfortable zone. So when it comes time to change and to do things differently, the ego, the mind, will step in and do its best to keep you safe and comfortable. It also supports your needs and desires. Your ego supports your needs and desires. Now, before we go on, you know, every once in a while I like to digress to incorporate some of my own personal things that happen throughout the days and things I think, and I, you know, do some philosophical exploration, if you will. But before I go on, I want to expand on an area that I find quite fascinating, and you may as well find this fascinating. In the Western world and the developed world, the more educated we become, this is my observation, the more educated we become, I find it fascinating that people in our society seem to struggle, they seem to be struggling to find their purpose. They're struggling to find their identity or the raison d'être. What is it? What are they meant to be? Their reason for being. Is it because we are educated? Is it because we're educated and prosperous and accustomed to having the simpler things in life, life's simple pleasures? Now, we live in a part of the world where, you know, we may not be considered rich in our part of the world, but in other people's eyes, we're doing quite well. So we have grown up in a custom that allows for abundance and allows for great things. And you know, we live in a place where we have, you know, clean water available to us. We have food available to us.